Welcome to North Shore Satsang. I enjoy this video background. There's a lot of turmoil out in the ocean, just like the world. But here on the beach, it's very beautiful and peaceful, safe, secure, just sitting here on the sand, watching the waves come in. It's a great place for satsang. Sitting is about the only thing I can do right now. Wiped out, physically wiped out from too much hard work, too much labor, clearing all the heavy junk out of a location, getting rid of everything that's heavy and dense and dead. Massive job. So at least I can talk. That's about it. But sometimes it's a good thing to be tired, because one will say things then which maybe wouldn't otherwise say. And there's some things I can say right now that maybe never get said in this world. I've never heard it. I wish I had heard it. Maybe I should title this Satsang, What Your Guru Should Have Told You. It's the very heart and key of success. Our situation is that we are spirit and we wanted to be prime creator. We wanted to see if we could be prime creator. Now, let's say a child wants to be prime, wants to be its own creator. What does the child have to do? It has to forget its parents. It has to deny that its parents are its parents. Just so, spirit has to deny prime creator if it wants to be prime creator. Spirit has to be in total denial and say, no, I created myself. I'm self-created. Nothing created me. Okay? So spirit is playing out this scenario of effects, pretending to be separate from cause. Now, what spirit did was it's imagining some effects. Some prime effects it's imagining. And you can call those effects God or Goddess. I call it God Goddess or Goddess, but God Goddess. Good enough. And this God Goddess, spirit is projecting it in such a way as this God Goddess is completely unaware that it's being projected or being created. It thinks it's self-created. It thinks it's prime creator. It thinks it made spirit. Okay? Just like spirit wants to believe that it made the prime creator, that spirit's the prime creator, and the prime creator is actually the prime creation. In other words, to reverse the direction of creation. Exactly the same in existence. Spirit is trying to show this principle that effect is actually the cause of cause, reversing, turning everything upside down. So this God Goddess that spirit is imagining believes that it created us, created spirit, and spirit has projected all these bodies, projected itself as identity as if it were bodies here in this world. So, for all intents and purposes, we believe that the God Goddess created us, bodies. That's what we're told, that's what we believe, and the God Goddess believes it. The God Goddess believes that it is the prime creator, and that created all of this universe, and it's in charge, and it can do whatever it wants, and it's the authority. But the fact is that its spirit is projecting this God Goddess, completely unaware that it's being projected, that it's being manifested, created by spirit. It thinks it's the prime creator. It believes that it created spirit, so spirit is under its authority, which makes it very, very difficult here in this world. It's like we have a complete lunatic in this universe, a believes that it created everything, whereas, as a matter of fact, it's spirit that's manifesting everything in this universe. It's spirit that's manifesting the God Goddess. But the God Goddess cannot be aware of this and denies it entirely. It was created, projected to deny this, to deny authorship. 100% denial of authorship. That is what we're faced with. If you wonder why are you having such a tough time, it's because there is this roadblock, so to speak, of 100% denial of authorship. So we feel that somehow this God Goddess is in control of us, created us, and we therefore have to submit to its authorship and what it wants to do. And the fact is that this God Goddess is absolutely doesn't have a clue about salvation. This God Goddess tells us to pursue enlightenment. Now, enlightenment really means, get this very clearly now, because this is something you've never heard before. The pursuit of enlightenment is really, the purpose is to recognize God Goddess as our creator, as that which created us, spirit. And so God Goddess is trying to get us all to recognize this, because God Goddess recognizes a problem with us, because somehow we don't give God Goddess full obeisance, you know. We don't believe entirely that we were created by God Goddess. And so God Goddess is telling us we must pursue enlightenment, we must become enlightened, meaning we must recognize God Goddess as our creator. Now, what is wrong with this? Well, it's a complete lie. Which is why the real teachers tell you to forget about enlightenment. That's not it. What is it is the overlay, which I've spoken about, and I repeatedly bring that up in just about every video. Choosing a different idea, choosing not to try and be prime creator, which means you don't need to deny authorship, which means we don't need to be in a position of trying to be enlightened, trying to accept false authorship of ourselves, of what we are. So enlightenment seems very, very difficult. Well, that's because we can never convince ourselves entirely that God Goddess created us, because Prime Creator created us. That's why in some of the high teachings of Hinduism, for instance, they say there's Brahman, there's God, and then Parabrahman, which is the real God. There's a real God and there's a fake God. And monotheism says there's only one God. That's true. There's only one real God. But there's also a fake God Goddess. And we are... It believes its mission is to get us... Its mission is to get us to recognize it as our creator. As prime creator. It's not prime creator. Not even close. It's just an expression of the denial of authorship that spirit is manifesting, is projecting, because spirit wants to deny that it was authored by Prime Creator. So its effects deny that they were authored by spirit. That's how it works. So now you've heard it. Takes a little getting used to. Because we've invested, you know, in this Ponzi scheme of enlightenment, trying to submit to what we're told created us, when in fact, we created that. We created the God Goddess. We're projecting it. We're responsible. We're sustaining it. We're the origin. We're the author of God Goddess. Spirit. We're spirit. We're the author of this universe, this entire dance. And we're telling ourselves that we are actually not the author of all this, but the God Goddess is the author of all this, and is the author of us as well. And so we're trying to conform to that. It's like putting a square peg in a round hole. We cannot conform to that, ever. But Spirit keeps telling itself that it's bad, it's wrong, it's guilty, it needs to find a way to conform to this, and there's some spiritual path of enlightenment that will result in us finally seeing the light and realizing that we were created by God, Goddess. There's no such truth at all that can be ever be found. Which is why you sometimes get teachers who claim this, who go off the deep end, get off the tracks, and get really nutty. Because it's not true. They end up getting used by the God Goddess, even though they're saying that now they're in one with it or in control of it or whatever. It doesn't work. This is the ultimate scheme or scam, is spirit projecting a God Goddess, a so-called author of itself. Something other than Prime Creator, you see? It's trying to prove that effects are the cause of cause. So it says, well, this God has created me, spirit, so I must have created Prime Creator, that principle. Spirit is stuck with this dynamic. And the only way out, there's only one way out, which is to choose a new idea. Choose the idea of not being Prime Creator. The way out is not to try and align with the God Goddess. That's the way to not get out. That's the way to remain deluded. So all these attempts at enlightenment, we wonder why have we failed? You know, because it's impossible to succeed. You can never align truth with a lie. It's impossible. The God Goddess did not create us. Didn't create anything. Spirit is the one who's manifesting all of this, sustaining it. There's a vast false evidence that effect is somehow separate from cause and can be the cause of cause. Therefore, spirit can believe that spirit is the true Prime Creator, and the Prime Creator is actually being caused by spirit. You see that reversing the direction. So now spirit's in existence. Spirit says, oh, Goddess is the Prime Creator of all of this and is the cause of everything, including spirit. Very simple, very basic. Not a teaching that you're going to hear in this world for various reasons. It's intuitively touched upon in all the great teachings that there's something isn't quite right, that the observer of all of this itself is part of all of this. That's another way. It's not as clear or direct, I don't believe, as what I'm saying here, but it's touching upon something that is a similar, different way of saying it. But for instance, someone's watching a television show and you say, oh, okay, there's an observer and there's a television show. But then the fact is that the observer of the television show and the television show are itself a television show on a bigger television, and that there is actually an observer of all of that. There's Brahman and there's Parabrahman. Brahman is an illusory, false God-Goddess that spirit is imagining. It's imagining that it has some power to be the creator of what it is that's imagining it, the origin. And this God-Goddess is a complete despot, complete dictator. It believes that that you belong to it, you are its creation. And that you're bad and guilty because you don't recognize this fact enough. And it has no hesitation to put bodies through infinite torture and misery and suffering. All in an attempt to so-called, quote-unquote, purify. So get rid of this some kind of stubbornness of not recognizing what created it. Complete madness. Because God Goddess did not create any of this, not projecting or imagining any of this. It's 100% coming from spirit. It's like a puppet in a puppet show, believing that it's the one that's doing all the motion, not the puppeteer. And then cursing the puppeteer for not truly believing it 100%, and telling the puppeteer that it has to go through all sorts of incarnations and have a spiritual evolution so it can finally recognize this supreme fact, that somehow it's not yet capable of recognizing this supreme fact. We are capable right this instant of recognizing the truth, because there's no difficulty to it. It's only when we're trying to make a lie true that there's this massive spiritual evolution stuff going on, and we think, oh, we must go through all these cycles, you know, so many incarnations, so much growth, so much integration, so much accumulation of growth and insight. And eventually we purified of all impurity, all this nonsense. That's only because we're trying to make a lie true. Truth is already true. We're the ones who are trying to make a lie true. That effect is the cause of cause. It's the origin. Effect is its own origin. That somehow arose spontaneously. Without any origin at all. Self-created. And that we're the self-created one. And that we created the prime creator. Not true, not true, not true. So, the fact that it's not true is true right now, right this moment. This fact is an actual fact. It doesn't have to go through any incarnations to be true, to be a fact. We don't have to do anything for all this to be a fact. So the factuality, the actuality of the whole situation is here right now. Better place to see this is you're sitting here on the North Shore watching the waves come in like this, warm gentle breeze, watching the sunset. We can just say, wow, that's cool, that's really great. Finally I hear that, I see it. It's part of my consideration, contemplation. The way is really the way of opening up to the clarifications that one has not previously heard or considered. And if one says, wow, that's great, it's a little shocking, a little unfamiliar, but I like what it's saying, then that means, you know, there's progress really being made. Maybe we don't see it perfectly right away, or we try to stuff it into some context that it won't fit into. But still, we realize that there is something that needs to be looked at, and we can look at it. And that's crucial, because the world is not looking in the right place. You wonder why it's so much difficulty finding answers, because the world is not looking in the right place. The world is looking to try to conform itself to what it believes to be the author of itself, when in fact it is not the author of itself, of us. Trying to conform to a fake author, fake authority, fake god-goddess, an imaginary god-goddess. No matter how many rituals we do, incantations, prayers, meditations, none of it will work. Never had a chance of working, because this imagined God Goddess isn't real. It's not our creator. And so no amount of worship is going to make it. So we can't make it real. We can't make it lie true. It's impossible. So all of these efforts to be enlightened is really an effort to make a lie true. So we really only need to give up these efforts. You've heard probably some great teachers say, just give up the effort, you know, stop seeking. That is true when it's understood in the right context. Give up your enlightenment. Give up trying to be enlightened. That's the booby prize. Enlightenment really is the booby prize. The real prize is to choose a different idea. Idea of not trying to be prime creator. And that gives rise to an effect which is not trying to get rid of anything. Which just lets everything simply be. Without trying to change anything. It's an overlay, perfect overlay. It overlays remembrance, it overlays forgetfulness, it overlays attempts to enlighten, to be enlightened, failure to be enlightened. It overlays laziness, it overlays industry, industriousness, it overlays God, goddess, overlays imagination, false ideas, everything equally overlaid. All syndromes, all situations. Nothing that it doesn't overlay. That is the real prize. That's the peace beyond understanding. Forget about enlightenment. That will never be attained. Alignment with a lie can never be attained. Because what kind of meaningful alignment can it be? It cannot be. It can only be plausible. Whereas the overlay is actual. And nothing has to change first. Because whatever is right now will be overlaid. So why does anything have to be changed? Not even the next moment needs to be. Nothing has to change. Because everything right now will be overlaid perfectly. Everything. Every last thought that you have, the observer of the thoughts that you're having is also overlaid. The awareness of the thoughts is overlaid. If everything is perfectly overlaid right now, why should we wait? Remember you say, well, it's enjoyable to watch the waves on the ocean out there. Sure, it is. But it's even better to have the overlay there. And as we look at the overlay, it becomes more and more clear how simple and easy it is, and that nothing has to be changed in your personality or anyone in any situation in the world at all. Exactly the way everything is right now, that is overlaid. Without any distinctions or judgments or exclusions. That old paint on the wooden wall there, decaying roof, that's overlaid. Don't have to put a new coat of paint on the house or fix the roof. Let's say you're too lazy to do it. That laziness is also overlaid. Let's say you're tired. That's overlaid. Everything, complete, total overlay, every situation, inclination, thought, desire, confusion, clarification, the entirety, the entire syndrome of existence is overlaid right now. With the idea of not trying to be prime creator. Nothing has more overlay than anything else. Nothing has less, more or less. Equal vision. Because the purpose is to simply to reflect, not trying to reverse the direction of creation, not trying to change anything, not trying to distort, not trying to deny. So this overlay is pure. It's inherently pure from the very beginning. There's no need to purify it. All our efforts to be enlightened and purify, that too is overlaid. The overlay is, from the very beginning, is perfectly pure and untarnishable. no process that needs to take place whatsoever to make it that way. And all we have to do is keep going in that direction and looking to see just how wide its ramifications are, how easy it is. We say, that too can be overlaid. That too is overlaid. The entirety of that, not just parts of it. We can be entirely free of that. We all have syndromes. We look out in this world and experiencing things that just, we feel caught up in them, caught up in it, and kind of pushed around by it. Because that's what thoughts do. Reactions, emotions, feelings, everything. It's all the activity of existence. All the thoughts we think we're thinking, also the same reactions to what's taking place, part of what's taking place, all of that, the entire syndrome, including the one who's observing all of it, that's overlaid. The observer is overlaid too, because the observer is actually also part of the dream. This hypothetical scenario of reversing the direction of creation, trying to find the power of negation over prime creator, trying to establish spirit as prime creator. This whole hypothetical dream scenario also gives rise to an observer who's watching it all. That too is overlaid, along with everything that it's observing, all the thoughts and everything that's bubbling up in this existence. That's a key point, because we think that there will be a still observer that's not overlaid, observing everything that is overlaid. No, the observer is also overlaid equally with everything else. That changes everything. So, the observer and everything the observer is observing or experiencing, all of that is equally overlaid. This is not enlightenment. This is something vastly better. Can't even say better, because enlightenment, you can never reach it. You never make a lie true. So this is real salvation, actual salvation. This is the vision of Christ, vision of oneness, nirvana, equal vision. Abiding as the self. All phrases for the exact same overlay. Peace beyond understanding. Seamless coat. Completely gentle. Completely untouched by all turmoil, all syndromes, all reactions. Have no effect on it because it's overlaying all of them. Total overlay right this instant. Nothing needs to change first. There's nothing here that overlay needs to wait for, because it can't overlay it. It needs to somehow change, or the observer has to see something better or different in order for the overlay to be successful. No, because the observer too is being overlaid. We don't have to worry at all what the observer is observing, because whatever the observer is observing, that too is overlaid. The overlay is a sovereign remedy. One sovereign remedy. And we are inching our way toward it. As we get free of this crazy authority problem of existence, thinking that somehow we're supposed to please the God-Goddess and do what pleases them. If we try to do what pleases them, we will simply continue to be tortured. Because that's very cruel. Very, very cruel. Because they're very frustrated. Because something within them, they don't know what created them. They think they created themselves, but they feel incomplete. That's because what a lie always feels incomplete. And they blame us for that. We're blamed. Because we're somehow not acknowledging them as creators, and they feel that's the incompleteness that they're feeling. It's a projection. So here we are, suffering for this projection. But the incompleteness that is felt is the fact that they are projected as not knowing what is projecting them. They're being imagined as that which is not aware that they're being of what it is that's imagining them. So they feel this incompleteness, a feeling of lostness. They don't know what they are. And then we get blamed for that. They project that onto us, and we're to blame. So we're always trying to make this world a more beautiful place, really nice, and show how inspired we are, working at the level of effects here, trying to show how the God-Goddess can inspire us to do great things. We try to please them. All for naught. All for naught. Waste of time. Useless. Totally useless. It's like an endless Ponzi scheme. We can never satisfy God Goddess's displeasure with us, because really comes from spirit projecting them as not knowing what is projecting them, to be in denial of what is projecting them. That's the dissatisfaction that's there. We're not to blame for that. Well, as spirit, we are to blame. We're the one causing it, but it won't get remedied by spirit making bodies and torturing those bodies. No. Only gets remedied by choosing a different idea. Exchange the idea of wanting to be prime creator with the idea of not wanting to be prime creator. Accepting, spirit accepting itself as it is. Without wanting to change what it is, wanting to be its own creator, having created itself. Because that leaves spirit with this feeling of not knowing what it really is. And so spirit doesn't like that feeling, feels lost, incomplete. Never remedy this feeling at the level of effects that it's projecting. How can you blame the effects for this and claim, you know, say, you got to work harder, you have to work faster, you have to build a better world, this will satisfy me? That's literally the situation we're in. We believe this God Goddess has created us and wants us to work for it and do wonderful things for it. And we slave away in existence in effects and matter and energy, trying to build something worthy that will please the God Goddess. We don't realize that it's all futile, completely futile. All this grandiosity that we are coming up with to try and glorify the God Goddess, completely futile. It will never accomplish what we hope it will accomplish. We even used to have blood sacrifices to the God Goddess, trying to appease its terrible frustration, displeasure with us. Futile. This pleasure comes from not knowing its origin. When spirit tries to deny God the Prime Creator, there's this feeling of great displeasure. Spirit feels wrong. No amount of grandiosity of construction can appease this feeling, can get rid of it. So we labor in vain. We'll continue to labor in vain until we see through this whole situation, which is very simple and easy. We have seen it through it right here on the Satsang. The overlay will overlay all grandiosity. all the vastness, grandiose vastness that we are working on. We try and please what we think, believe is the author of our existence. Because we keep wondering, why is existence this? Everything dies. Everything is impermanent here. It's terrible. Can't we, you know, please the author of existence and be free of this misery? Everything dies here because we're trying to invent a power of negation that can be used to negate the prime creator, get rid of it entirely. Because denial is seen as not enough. The spirit realizes, you know, just simply forgetting and denying needs to be reinforced. So we have this very frustrating situation. We believe the God-Goddess will somehow solve it for us. Cannot. It didn't make it. It didn't. It's not the author of all this. The author of all this is us, the spirit. And our idea of wanting to be prime creator gives rise to all of this and the way that it is. So the only way is to, as spirit, choose a different idea. Not to keep praying to God, Goddess, to heal us or make us feel better. That doesn't work. Or enlighten us. That doesn't work. Or align us. Give us some perfect alignment with God, Goddess. Doesn't work. Because God, Goddess will always feel incomplete, doesn't know what it is, and will blame it on us, saying, by telling us we need to be enlightened somehow, we have to somehow complete the incompleteness of God, Goddess. How can we do that? How can people, humans, or anything, complete the incompleteness of God, Goddess, as long as this idea is being held by spirit, which is for effect to deny its authorship. Problem, the incompleteness is that spirit is projecting God, Goddess, to not know what is projecting it. So that there's an inherent incompleteness within this entire idea. Completely, from the very beginning, inherently there. The only way to solve it is to choose a different idea. We cannot complete the incomplete. As the very purpose of existence is to project this, that which has this sense of incompleteness because it doesn't know what authored it. This is the dynamic that arises from the idea. You cannot have an idea without the dynamic arising from it. It's impossible. You can't say, well, we can keep the idea of wanting to be prime creator, but somehow we can complete the incompleteness of God, Goddess. Impossible. Completely impossible. But the overlay overlays all of this. It overlays the impossibility of it. It overlays the incompleteness of God, Goddess. It overlays the displeasure of God, Goddess. It overlays the wearisome toil of us wanting to try and complete the God, Goddess. It overlays all our prayers, petitions, misery, suffering, hope, false hope, all our efforts, all the grandiosity. The totality of the entire idea and dynamic is overlaid by not trying to get rid of anything, by not trying to deny authorship, by not trying to deny cause and effect. Seamless, perfect overlay. That is the actual way. When you look at it from this perspective, changes everything. Changes from futility to actual hope. That's the whole purpose of the satsang, is to make that slight shift into real hope, actual hope. Actually feeling, knowing, yeah, there really is a way. The reason why I failed is because I was trying to do it a way that can never succeed. I cannot complete the God Goddess, no matter what I do. By sacrificing myself, I can't complete. Can't give any completion to it. By working nonstop, I can't give any completion to it. No matter what I do, it will never be enough. It will never complete. Because because spirit is projecting and sustaining the projection of the god goddess, of not knowing what is projecting it. And that will always be the dynamic of the idea of wanting to be prime creator. So you can never solve at the level of effects. It can only be solved at the level of cause, of choosing ideas. Spirit must choose a new idea as the sovereign remedy. Choosing the idea of not wanting to be prime creator, that will give rise to the overlay. The overlay overlays the entirety of the idea of wanting to be prime creator without needing to change anything, without having to change any effect whatsoever. All effects that arise are overlaid to the totality of the madness, the strife, the turmoil, the struggle. Look out at that ocean. And you see the ceaseless waves in the white water. Never exactly the same. Constantly, constantly. Just think of that throughout, you know, billions of years. Waves constantly breaking like this. Always slightly different. Never the same. The overlay overlays all of that. All of it. Right now. Overlays all of time. Past, present, future. Completely unconcerned about what does and what doesn't arise. And when and where it arises makes no difference. It overlays unawareness of the overlay. So the observer is unaware of the overlay. The overlay overlays this unawareness, this denial, everything. So nothing has to be changed. And of course nothing can be changed really about the dynamic of the idea of wanting to be prime creator. It plays out as it must play out. The overlay overlays all of the play simultaneously, without any distinction, no more, no less, no judgment. That's the remedy. That's the remedy we're pointing to. That's the sovereign remedy. This may be what your guru has never told you, but should have told you. Some do in their own way and style. And then some don't, because some are teaching you of how to align with God Goddess, and they telling you that they know the way, which is not true. They don't know the way, and they tell you they have all these, you know, ways to do it, and they can teach you how to do it, and they can, you know, it doesn't work. Eventually it's realized, hey, you know, something's wrong here, it's not working. So there are always those in this world who claim that they know the way to be enlightened, to align with God Goddess. And there are also those who will tell you that it's impossible to align with God Goddess. But what you really need to do is drop that effort and choose a new idea, exchange ideas. And then that is the actual way to salvation. And the overlay overlays all the teachers that come that don't teach this, who tell you there is a way. It overlays all that. No judgment. Overlays the good, the bad, and the ugly equally. Doesn't need judgment. For what? It's not trying to change anything. If there's no effort to change anything, how does that feel? Feels right now. Right here, right now. Complete gentleness, complete peace. Right here, right now. Inescapable. Not trying to move anywhere. All right. Very great. Enjoy the North Shore.